During a virtual conference late last year, I was having a chat with a CIO from Asia Pacific, and he was frustrated because due to new security and compliance requirements, he needed to provide the business with a highly available storage infrastructure. So after receiving a very expensive proposal from his storage vendor, well, first of all, he was not happy with that. And it was not only the price, the cost of the solution, I mean, but the increasing complexity by adding appliances on top of what he has today. So he asked me, "Hey, what IBM has to offer in this field? Because I really don't know what to do." My answer to break the ice of the conversation was, "You don't need to be highly skilled, neither pay the cost of a Ping machine in order to have high available storage." And then he asked me, "What is a Ping machine?"
What do I do?
Nothing, dear. You're not qualified. Leave it to us.
What's that for?
That's the machine that goes bing.
So I spent a few minutes explaining my joke. It was not a joke anymore. And where did I took it from? Right after this awkward episode caused by me, I started explaining a little bit of IBM Flight System Hyperswap feature and how it could help him, taking the advantage of not increasing the complexity of the environment and actually keeping the costs down. And talking about costs, the downtime costs can quickly reach millions, right? I had another video in this series that I explain a little bit more about this, but it can actually reach millions of dollars of damage to the organizations with a few unreliable systems. So take a look on this. I will put the study on the description of this link as well. So before having a major outage causing financial damage to the organization, we started work on a storage high available project. Again, when we talk about projects like this, it is not only about technology. Technology has a very important part, but it's also about trained people and proper process. And all that I like to separate into at least three tiers of protection. The first tier, local HA or local high availability, dual controller, dual path, drive parity, dual energy source. All this because you don't want to swap sites if you don't need to, right? Even because statistically, the majority of the outages are not in the whole site, but in part of it, like few systems only. So we need to handle this differently. The second tier, yes, disaster recovery. We have the whole primary site down. What to do? Now we need to run the business from the secondary site. Are we ready for this? And then backup, the last tier, the last line of defense. The primary site is down. The secondary site is compromised. What to do? We need to have protected copies of your data in order to build everything from scratch, right? So air-gapped, immutable are key features here. So in order to have the lowest RPO and RTO as possible, we use IBM Spectrum Virtualize in different locations, and we enable a function called Hyperswap. In this short demo, I am leaving my dear lab in Kesselbach, Germany, and saying hi to IBM Tucson lab infrastructure in Arizona. So in this special launch episode, my friend Chris Keller, IBM storage guru, will guide us on a very cool demo about Hyperswap. Stay tuned.
Today we will walk through the Hyperswap feature of the IBM Flash System family. Hyperswap is storage high availability that allows hosts and applications to continue in the event of a complete storage controller failure. How it works is both storage systems maintain complete synchronous copy with each other in active-active configuration. A Hyperswap volume is presented from both storage controllers to the hosts. In the event of a complete storage controller failure, the hosts simply see half the paths go offline and continue operation through the available controller. What we are viewing is the Flash System UI in HyperSwap mode. Controller Enclosure 1 is located at Site 1, and Controller Enclosure 2 is located at Site 2. I have created a pool of storage at each site designated as East Pool and West Pool to identify the physical locations. Viewing HyperSwap volumes shows fully synchronous copies at each of the locations. Take note of the HS DataStore A and HSU01 volumes, as we'll be working with VMware and Oracle in this demonstration. As mentioned previously, HyperSwap is an active-active configuration. However, if you have clustered hosts, it's best for those hosts to communicate with the storage controllers closest to them. Designating a host to a site allows the storage controllers to notify the host to use optimal paths. We will be using Iometer as our mission-critical application loaded within a VMware guest. You can see the VM is tied to HS DataStore A that currently has all 8 paths online. Our second application is Oracle on Power AIX, mounted on the U01 volume. Selecting everything from the data table, we currently have 11 rows of information. The second green screen shows the current multipathing state. I've written a simple script that injects incrementing numbers into the data table using the insert into command. Back to our VMware guest, starting Iometer drives about 90,000 IOPS. Pivoting back over to the Flash System UI, it reflects the recent I/O workload. I've written two administrative scripts, one of which will crash an entire storage controller. Executing the crash array script, you will notice a momentary pause in I/O while multipathing drivers readjust workload to the remaining paths. Both Oracle and Iometer continue their workload even with a completely failed controller. AIX MPIO will refresh with degraded or failed paths, and shortly after, the Flash System UI will throw out a very impressive number of error conditions. Looking at the HyperSwap configuration, you'll notice that Site 2 is completely offline. Peering into the volumes, the related copies are also offline. Meanwhile, application I/O still continues. If we go back to VMware, we can see half of the 8 paths are offline. When the crashed array is powered back up, only change blocks are updated from the active controller and error events will be cleared. This is a fully automated operation. HyperSwap is a feature that has been part of this family for many years. It's quite stable and easy to set up. I hope this video was helpful. If there are any questions, please reach out to me anytime.
That was pretty much it for today. I hope you have enjoyed it. Don't forget to watch Barry's video about HyperSwap. It is from IBM System Back to School 2020 playlist. Probably will appear somewhere around me, so give it a go. It gives more details on how does it work and how to deploy it, right? So, kia kaha, my dear Auckland City, one more week in lockdown. We got this. Let's go. Woohoo! See you next week. Bye.